Okay, so for this next video lecture, so we are still in the elements of the system of internal control. So this is the last element, control activities. Okay, so here, control activities, this refers to the policies and procedures that help ensure that management directives are carried out. So here, these are actually the procedures that is being implemented, okay? Control activities include information processing controls, the general IT controls, both of which may be manual or automated in nature. Okay, so for the general information technology controls, so this is the controls over the entity's IT processes. Okay, it supports the continued proper operation of the IT environment, which includes continued effective functioning of information processing controls and the integrity also of the information in the entity's information system. Okay, so here these controls focus on the general information technology. Okay, so here, this is on how the data are being processed as well as the safety of the information of the entity. What about information processing controls? So these are controls relating to the processing of information in IT applications or even manual information processing in the entity's IS. So this directly addresses the risk to the integrity of information, like for example, the completeness, accuracy, and validity of transactions and other information. So this is how information is being processed and turn it into an output or report. Okay, so controls in the control activities pertains to the following. Okay, first we have the authorization and approvals. So here, an authorization, this will affirm that a transaction is valid. Okay, just like what we have discussed under the administrative controls. Okay, so it takes the form of an approval by the higher level of management or verification and determination if the transaction is valid. So here, meaning before a transaction could take place, it should be authorized by the higher management. Maybe through the signature that is indicated in the document, okay, or with any written form of communication that states that it allows this type of transaction to happen. Okay, so in authorization, this can either be general or specific. Okay, when we say general authorization, this is granted to operations personnel to perform their day-to-day operations, meaning in general authorization, these are the inherent activities that are actually understood by the management that the employees will do this task on a day-to-day basis on their operations. That's why it is considered to be general, okay, because the management understand that it is necessary for this transaction to occur, for the operation to go smoothly. This is an essential part of their business transactions, okay, that is for the general authorization. Okay, for instance, employees are authorized to purchase inventories from designated vendor only when inventory levels fall to their predetermined reorder points. So in this case, there is some sort of policy or guideline, okay, in the purchase of these inventories. Once the inventory level fall below the reorder point, that is the time, or this is the their determining point. It's like a determining point or what do you call that? It's like their limit, okay? In which if this level is reached, the repurchase for inventory will or should take place, and the purchase will only be for or from the designated vendor. Okay, so that is general authorization. For specific authorization, on the other hand, this deals with a case-by-case decision, okay, associated with non-routine transactions. So, for example, the decision to extend a particular customer's credit limit beyond the normal amount. So, in this case, for specific authorization, this actually needs the immediate approval of higher management, or if in this example the customer has met a certain policy on credit extension, so they will be allowed, okay, and other things. But again, under specific authorization, this is for the case-by-case decision which are associated with non-routine transactions, meaning these transactions are rare and this is not very common to occur on a day-to-day basis, unlike with that of under the general authorization. I mean, the general authorization, it's not day-to-day, but it's an important function that should take place on a periodic basis, but this one is non-routine. Okay, so controls and the control activities pertain to the following. Okay, aside from the authorization, reconciliation is next. So reconciliations will compare two or more data elements. So it differences, or its differences are identified. So if there is differences, actions will be taken to bring the data into agreement. That is for reconciliation. That is the purpose of reconciliation, to determine if there is deviation or differences and bring them into agreement. Okay, so that in this case, they will know the reasons, or they will know what are the differences, they should know what are the reasons, and they should take actions for it. Okay, next is verification. So here, verifications compare two or more items with each other, or compare an item with a policy. Meaning, in this case, if the existing record is the same with the physical existence of that item, or if that document or transaction is in accordance with what is being authorized. Okay, so here it's confirming if that transaction is valid also. So it will likely to involve a follow-up action when the two items do not match, or the item is not consistent with the policy. Okay, so this is part of the monitoring and appraisal process. Another is physical or logical controls. So in this case, this will include those that addresses security of asset against unauthorized access, acquisition, use, or disposal. So here, this focus on the safeguarding of the assets. Okay, physical or logical controls. This is especially for making sure that these transactions related to assets are authorized as well. So these are controls also to physically safeguard the asset, okay, such as secured facilities or facilities over access to assets, records, authorization for access to computer programs, data files, and periodic counting and comparison with the amount shown on the control records. Okay, so this is how physical or logical controls are being implemented. Okay, another is an effective physical or logical control means that only personnel who are authorized should have the access to assets and records. Okay? So, meaning they do some, or they have some passwords or login requirements, okay, for them to take these transactions into place. Okay, another is segregation of duties. So here, this is the assigning of different people with different responsibilities. So this will reduce the opportunity to allow any one person to be in a position to be both perpetuate and conceal errors or frauds in the normal course of the person's duties. So in this case, a segregation of duties meaning accounting should be separate from financial operations. Recording should be different from those who are handling cash transactions or cash account. Recording is different from those who are making reconciliations of bank reconciliations. Recording should be separated from those who are depositing the cash. Recording should be different for those who are accepting cash and so on. Okay, so that in this case, of those who are transacting for cash accounts are different persons, okay, who are recording such transactions to avoid errors or fraud. Okay. So the consequently, the following responsibilities must be separated as well. Authorization of transaction should be different, should be handled by a different person for those who are recording the transaction, and as well as the custody of asset. This is what we are talking about. Okay, a different person should authorize the transaction, a different person should record the transaction, and a different person should handle that account or asset. So that there will be no one person who can perpetuate, okay, to commit error or even fraud. Okay. So, for instance, a credit manager who is responsible to authorize the credit sales, the authorization, should not be responsible for maintaining the accounts receivable records, the recording, or handling the cash receipts or custodial. Because, for example, if just imagine if this three responsibilities are handled by one person, so meaning cash is really susceptible to theft. Okay, and any theft can be concealed because there is only one person who handles, records, and authorizes these transactions. That's why it's very important for them to be separated. Okay, so those are for our control activities.